Oh my gosh, so we're watching the royal wedding, and I didn't think about it until now, but I had to pull out my camera.
And the moon is the only light we see. No, I won't be afraid. No, I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand by me.
Y'all, I missed the black choir, but the black choir slayed. Stand by me. They was putting that white choir to shame, okay? This is the blackest wedding ever. I love it. Right now, guys, it's 7:30 in the morning, and I don't feel like turning on the lights.
Yeah, I just woke her up.
So, if you can't see me, that's too bad. They even had the black preacher. He was getting real church on him, talking about love. And then he was talking about fire. And then he was talking about love and fire and the fiery love. George Clooney got his first taste of black church today. And all these people got their first taste of black church today. If they had given that black pastor more time, he would have taken it. Trust me. Trust me.
You missed the heart of the whole ceremony though, to put on your blog.
Oh, I don't care about the hats.
But that's all about the wedding and the fascinators.
Good for them. I'm not fascinated.
Look, the little black boy singing your heart out.
I'm like, why are they zooming in on him? Like, that was my thought process when I saw that. Why are they zooming in on him? They should have had him join the black choir. We're having some tea for the royal wedding. Some tea.
Yay!
They broke tradition.
Because they're not royals.
I know.
So I don't know if they get... Do they get to go on the balcony?
I have to fart.
Mother! Oh my God. Please, I don't want to smell it.
This procession will be about half an hour long. The streets of Windsor down the Long Dog.
Literally was not planning on reacting to this, but just saw the first 10 seconds and also saw that it's number 7 trending on YouTube, and I'm like, what the actual fuck? I need to react to this. So we're gonna start this over. I've only seen the first 15 seconds, but I didn't actually see the first 15 seconds because I was doing stuff and walking around, and then I came back and I literally saw what's on the screen at 16 seconds, which is this. And I'm like, WTF is going on with these Illuminati videos? We're gonna watch this in its entirety. Why are you carrying a cross upside down? Why is there a bunch of crosses and Jesus and a barren land and a church? These are some apocalyptic images. Why is there Mary and Jesus? Like, why is that pastor smiling?
get married like the Curry, Steph and Aisha shit. But we more like Belly, Tommy and Keisha shit. Bow, liking pictures, not returning texts. I guess it's bomb and I get the message.
What's his name? The model. What's his name? Tyson Beckford. Why is Tyson Beckford in this? I don't know.
It's a shit, man. I thought you would have learned your lesson about liking pictures, not returning texts. I guess it's fine, man. I get the message. Said that you was working, but you out here chasing culo and butas, chilling poolside, living two lives. I could have did what you did to me to you a few times, but if I did decide to slide, find a
nigga. I think at this point they were just still trying to hide the fact that she was pregnant because they have her in a big princess gown and she's holding the flowers in front of her stomach.
Suck his dick, you would have been pissed. But that's not my MO, I'm not that type of bitch. Be careful with me. Do you know what you're doing? Whose feelings that you're hurting and bruising? Be careful with me.
Why is he dressed like that?
My heart is like a package with a fragile label on it. Be careful with me.
So confusing. Again with the cross. Upside down. Symbol of the Antichrist.
Oh, you better treat me carefully. Look, I was here before all of this. Guess you acting now. You got an audience. You might have a fortune, but you lose me, you still gonna be misfortunate, nigga. Tell me, this love's got you this fucked up in the head. You want some random bitch up in your bed? You don't want someone who love you instead? I guess not, though. It's blame, disrespect. You nothing like the nigga I met. Talk to me crazy and you quick to forget. Tripping.
What
you
am I watching?
In the mirror different. Thinking I'm flawed because you inconsistent. It all stopped so abrupt. You started switching it up. Teach me to be like you so I cannot give a fuck. Free to mess with someone else. I wish these feelings come out. Cause you don't care about a thing except your motherfucking self. You made me sick, I adore. I gave you everything was mine is yours. I want you to live your life, of course.
Fucking hidden meanings in this.
What you listen to her.
Why did it keep showing the upside down cross? You gonna get the whole world. What is she saying? She's gonna kill him? Now the cross is upright.
It's not a threat, it's a warning. Be careful with me. Yeah. My heart is like a package with a fragile label on it. Be careful with me.
Yo, this has some hidden meanings, bro. Like, what did I just watch? Oh my god. Okay, so I watch a lot of Illuminati conspiracy videos on YouTube. They talk a lot about how the music industry is like corrupt and there's a lot of like Illuminati devil worshiper Freemason people in the music industry and how like they use a lot of religious images and people think that it's like harmless because they're using religious images, but it's actually like a blasphemy of these religious images, and like the inversion of a lot of these things is like actually going against religion. I'm not a very religious person, but it still makes me super uncomfortable that like people actually believe that this stuff to the extent to put it in artists' music videos. And I think a lot of these artists like don't know what these images mean that are in their music videos, and they're just showing up to work kind of thing. And that's scary. That's really freaking scary. I just know if this was my music video and somebody came to me with this treatment and tried to pitch it to me, I would say, what does that have to do with the song? Because a lot of these music videos have nothing to do with the song. Oh my god. Like, that was just, I don't know what that was. Like, what did that have to do with the song? You know? Anywho, that's my thoughts. Hey guys, so I'm just sitting outside of my side door just waiting for my boo thing to come and pick me up. And we're gonna go have some dinner on the patio. Ooh, is that her?
No, it wasn't.
but I'm just waiting for her to come grab me, and we're gonna go have a wonderful dinner.
She's crazy. Good, I'm so jealous of her. We are at St. Louis. I forgot to film my food, but I got a Caesar salad and chicken and waffles, which taste amazing. But the portion sizes are really small, and it took forever to get our food. Like, what time do we get here, do you think?
Chicken wings. Not cute. What time did I call you?
Yeah, we have text evidence. She called me. I'll check the text evidence, but she called me around, like, I'm gonna say, like, maybe 7:45-ish. Or 7:30. And we got here, like, literally 2 minutes after, because my house is, like, 2 minutes away from here. And we were driving. And it is now, what time? 8:45. So maybe it wasn't that long.
That is a long time.
Yeah, about an hour. And it really is. It's like waffles that I'm sure they just put in like a toaster. Chicken fingers and salad that I'm sure is prepackaged. And she got chicken wings and fries.
Cold fries.
And she said that her fries were cold, and they literally came out with hot fresh fries in 30 seconds.
Literally
30 seconds. I don't know. Anyways, we're talking about boys and life and catching up, and it's the best, the absolute best. Right now, we are in Caravana Carnival Wonderland. There's all these boas and feathers and jewels. Crazy. I didn't know a place like this existed. Look at this. So pretty. More feathers, bras, more jewels. Ooh. So pretty.
Guys, I just filmed my Take on Tuesday video, and I'm just loving how simple yet awesome and flawless my makeup is looking. So I just wanted to document that. Doesn't it look super cute? It's like a really simple like wash of like glittery champagne-y color on the lid, and then a little bit of like a dark brown in the crease. And I am wearing the Maybelline Fit Me foundation in the color 335 in their matte formula. Sephora's concealer as a contour in the color Devil's Food. A really old eyebrow pencil that I have. And the Maybelline Lash Sensational mascara. And I don't have any blush right now, so I actually use the Rimmel Kate Moss in the color 107 on my cheeks. And that is it. It's my entire makeup look. Cute, no? I'm feeling myself right now, y'all. So I'm scrolling through Instagram, and I see Drake post a picture of the Degrassi school sign that says welcome back, and the caption is link in bio. Drake, why you gotta do this? Why you gotta do this? I click on it and it's the video for I'm Upset. Now I listened to I'm Upset when he announced that it was out, like available on like Apple Music and Spotify and stuff like that. Did not like it. Drake always does this. He does like a hard hip-hop head type song that's like old school, like just some people I don't listen to kind of rap. But then he has some real good ass
freaking marketing, and he always trying to represent for his people and represent for Toronto, making me want to watch the video. So I click on it. I see it's number one trending. I watched like the first 15 seconds, and then I was like, no, 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 no. I gotta film this because this boy's at it again. He's at it again. All right, here we go. Drake. Like, he just does some like audacious shit to be like, I'm repping for my city. What person is gonna sleep on the basketball court of their favorite team? Like, he's like too much, but I love it all at the same time. Like, what? Oh my god. I think he's really just like enforcing the like, I'm the king of my city.
I'm upset. 50,000 on my head is disrespect. So offended that I had to double check. Can't go 50-50 with no hope.
Stop this! Oh my gosh, I can't remember his fucking name. What's his character's name? It's dude from Degrassi. I can't remember his freaking name.
Pay bills and get her what she want. I still got like 7 years of doing what I want. My dad still got child support from 1991. 100,000 on my head is disrespect. So offended that...
Oh my gosh! Dude, this is too much for my soul to handle.
Jump up out the bed like I'm possessed.
And their characters were like best friends on the show. Oh my god! Oh my gosh, it's Andrea Lewis! She's the only one who I actually freaking know, like her name. It's Andrea freaking Lewis!
SMS, triple X.
They even got the fucking teacher! AJ Soudan! I can't remember her fucking name. Cassie! I remember her character's name is Cassie.
Can't go 50-50 with no hope.
What the fuck? This is... Okay, that was just embarrassing. That was not cool.
She just putting on a front. She gonna try and settle out of court and make a run. They gonna ask me...
What am I watching?
Call this to Blind Jimmy.
Guys, I'm just gonna say it was kind of garbage last time, so it'd be like, interesting. Oh, God.
Okay, Drake, you're not funny. I don't know who's writing these skits, but like every time in recent years that your video has stopped for a skit, it has lost all momentum. Like, I was so hyped. I was like, hey. And then I'm like, what's the principal, what's his name? He was the principal on the show. Is buying weed from some fucking kids with long hair? Like, no.
You only live once, that's the motto, genie, YOLO.
Shut the fuck up!
Yeah. I'm upset.
Nina Dobrev! You could tell Nina Dobrev is, like, trying so hard to be into this. And, like, trying hard to, like, dance. And, like, she's, like, totally aware of, like, how not hip-hop she is.
To the left, to the left. Got a lot of blood and it's cold.
Whoa. Anybody else think that's a little bit insensitive with the current climate of school shootings? It's a little insensitive.
I didn't like that.
It brings me back to the days of when it was like, hey, how much now? It was like $15. And I was like, no lunch. Choking weed, doing Molly,
cooking beer. Okay, I don't remember those people from the show, so like, who are they and why are they here? This is not funny, Drake.
Hey, I know that guy too. Look.
Okay.
Look at that mess. Look at that. Hey, I know that guy too.
Oh, he's nobody. Drake. I'm upset with, like... Ah! Andrea! Oh, I get it! He was the one that shot Jimmy, so all his boys are coming to him. That is so funny. Okay, you redeemed yourself. Some things I didn't like. Okay, some things were really cheesy. Some things were like, what the F is happening here? Like the school setting on fire and the pop of the guns and whatever. Him sleeping on the floor of the basketball court. Like, what? I don't understand. But like, just the nostalgia, like, God, Drake knows how to represent for Toronto and pull on the nostalgia heartstrings at the same fucking time. He's a master of that. Ugh. I enjoyed that. I thoroughly enjoyed that. That was so, like, oh my gosh, memories. I feel like I need to show that to my sister. I need to show that to my cousin. Oh my god, those were the days. Degrassi's so bad now. It's such like a, I mean, I guess it always was like a overdramatic teenage soap opera, but I just notice it now more that I'm an adult. Still don't like the song, but the video I would give a 7 out of 10 for nostalgia points.